Welcome to our guide on how to set up a Visual Studio C# project to use the Kvaser CANlib software development kit. Before beginning, please make sure that you've installed CANlib and our latest drivers. In addition to the Visual Studio C# tools, you will need to install the Microsoft Visual C++ redistributable package. This package is necessary because the managed CANlib dynamic link libraries are created using C++. For our example, we're going to create a Windows C# console application. To do this, we will need to launch the new project wizard by selecting the new project link from the start page. Once the wizard is open, select Windows Desktop under Visual C# in the templates tree. Select console application from the template list. You may also choose your desired .NET framework from the drop menu above the available templates list. We need to create an application name and select a location for the project to be saved. Finally, press OK and Visual Studio will create the solution directory and associated project files. Once the project is opened, right-click on the project file in the Solution Explorer. Select Properties, and then under the Application tab, make sure that the target framework has the desired framework version. Next, we move to the Build tab to set the platform target. First, change the configuration to All Configurations, then select the desired platform target. The platform target cannot be set to any CPU. The CANlib dynamic link libraries are created using C++, which requires a specific target platform. Therefore, you must select a target platform for your project of x86 or x64. For this example, we will choose x64. Save these settings and then right-click on References in the Solution Explorer. Select Add Reference, and then browse to select the CANlib DLL file that matches your project's target platform and framework. In the CANlib installation directory, these files are sorted into different subdirectories by target platform, followed by framework version. First, we need to browse for .NET in the CANlib installation directory. Since we chose to work with the 4.5.1 framework and the x64 in this example, we will select the x64 folder and then select FW40 to see the available CANlib DLLs that are compatible with our project. For this project, we're working with communication on a Kvaser CAN interface, so we will choose CANlib CLSnet.dll. Once a selection has been made, it should appear under References in the Solution Explorer. We are now ready to add code that uses the CANlib API. To prove that the project is set up correctly, we will add the first couple of necessary lines to access the functions in the CANlib CLSnet.dll. We first add the CANlib CLSnet namespace to the project with the using directive. Then, in the main routine, we will add a call to the CANInitializeLibrary function. Now we can try building the project. Since the project builds without errors, we can make sure all the runtime components are present as well by attempting to run the project. Our example was able to launch without any runtime exceptions, so we know our libraries have been successfully linked to the project. For more information about CANlib, you can view our CANlib SDK help and check out our series of developer blogs.